The sixth graders of Fort Jennings Elementary, part of the Jennings Local School District, wish to thank the friends of this broadcast for their generous local support of this edition of News 6.
Welcome to this week's edition of News 6. Today's program is brought to you by the 6th grade class of Fort Jennings Elementary. Our school is part of the community of Fort Jennings in Putnam County. Founded in 1812, it has a population of about 454 people. Let's find out what issue is most on the mind of our 6th graders.
How do you think world peace can be achieved?
I believe world peace may never be achieved as long as there are people with evil minds and hearts.
I think world peace may be achieved by everyone working together to sign a world peace treaty.
We also can be nice to other countries and forget about the past.
We can achieve world peace by working out our problems with other countries. Also, we can just catch terrorists and leave the rest of the world alone.
I think world peace can be achieved if all weapons of mass destruction and terrorists are destroyed.
I think world peace can be achieved by working to help each other out.
This is the 6th grade classroom. We are here in the elementary office. The 6th graders work in the cafeteria each day. We serve food and clean tables. This is our library.
We are here outside launching our rockets. Take a look.
Dogs are sometimes like members of the family. We want them well cared for when we go away for a while. Jennifer Warnicky reports on a safe place they can stay.
Hello, I'm Jennifer Warnicky. Even dogs need a vacation. And they stay at Country Kennels in Fort Jennings. Marianne Swartz is the owner.
Country Kennels is a dog business where I board dogs when people go away. The majority of the owners leave their dogs here when they're going for a weekend getaway. We opened up May 27, 2001. I do all the cleaning and feeding myself, but every once in a while my husband Nate or my daughter Lindsay will help.
This place is a luxury hotel for canines.
We have 12 kennels, indoor and outdoor runs, so each dog has their own kennel, and they're 4x6 in size, which gives them plenty of room. Usually there's only one dog in each kennel, but if an owner has two or three small dogs, they can all fit in one kennel together.
It's almost like the dogs are fed breakfast in bed.
Every dog owner brings their own food, so the dog is used to its own food. Some dogs have the food in their bowl all day, and other dogs get fed twice a day. I walk them four times a day, and then usually right before bedtime, I let them outside in the play yard to go to the bathroom one more time. Put them on a leash, and we let them walk out in the yard. And they walk around for probably 3 to 4 minutes at a time. I own two dogs, a male and a female, and they're Bernice Mountain Dogs, and their names are Beau and Carly. The satisfying part of owning Country Kennels is being my own boss and setting my own hours.
This is Jennifer Warnicky reporting for News 6.
Thank you. I'm Ross Gerdeman with this week's New Six Review. Today, I'm examining the Xbox, a fun video game station with incredibly real graphics. While I'm destroying aliens, the Xbox can also play music as well. It can even spin DVDs. You need to budget your Xbox time because it can cut into important homework. Overall, it's a fun when you have your friends or family to play with you. It's a really nice gift. Check it out. For News 6 Review, I'm Ross Gerdeman.
When we get sick, our parents take us to the family doctor. The doctor helps us get well as quickly as possible. The same is true for animals. Tanner Adams reports on a place where we can bring our sick pets.
Hi, I'm Tanner Adams. Adolphus Couple shows our pets and large animals lots of TLC.
Well, this is Murphy. She's alive.
Doctors John and Bonnie Jones keep all animals healthy.
Do any of you have dogs?
Yeah.
Used to.
Well, we're veterinarians, so we're animal doctors. We spend most of our day taking care of animals, but we also help people. The main thing we do, we help educate owners about their animals and how to take care of them better. We take care of probably anywhere from 100 to 125 dogs and cats every week, and maybe 15 to 20 large animals, horses and cattle. Depends kind of on the day. The most satisfying thing about being a veterinarian is actually helping people with their animals. If they bring a sick animal to us and we can help the animal get better, but also help the person learn how to take care of the animal better.
The Jones also have animals of their own.
We have two dogs, probably 10 or 11 cats. We have 14 draft horses, 38 sheep, 9 chickens, and about 15 guinea hens.
Dr. John's job is very interesting.
Really every patient that comes in here has a story, and most of them have happy endings. What kind of pets does everybody here have?
I had a hamster named Twix.
You had a hamster? If a person wants to become a veterinarian, in school you want to take as much math and science classes as you can. Study hard and do the best you can, but the thing I think you need to learn the most is to learn how to learn.
This is Tanner Adams reporting for News 6.
Graders from Lima Bath Middle School celebrate Veterans Day.
That's all for this edition of News 6. Thanks for watching. Be sure to tune in next week for more news from around Northwest Ohio.
See ya!